Okay, hello, this is Blink-182, Adam's song, or as the British say, Blink-182. Anyway, so obviously Blink-182 is a big, I guess, what were they, I guess like pop punk band, whatever, kind of emo maybe. Anyway, I never heard the song, I'll be honest. I know Blink-182, just because obviously they're like a big band from the past 30 years or whatever it's been, 20 years, I guess, I don't know, I'm rambling now. But anyway, yeah, so I know the song is pretty popular. However, I've never listened to it. I probably listened to it, but like I never got into it. I don't know. I was more into songs like I Miss You and All the Small Things and like What's My Age Again or whatever. But like, yeah, I'm not like a huge Blink fan. And yeah, so Adam's song has kind of gone by the wayside until today. And so yeah, let's just get into this. And hopefully this video doesn't get taken down because I haven't reacted to Blink-182 yet. So let's see what happens. Let's go. Okay. And this is a lyrics video, so that's always nice. I'm just gonna hold on here. The whole I took my time, I hurried up, the choice was mine. I would say that that's a reference to a Nirvana song, Come As You Are. And yeah, I just noticed that off the bat and I wanted to pause that and say that. And also, I guess I could say that I see that this is not sung by Tom DeLonge, I think. And yeah, so this is Mark singing. So yeah, there's I know like they share vocals or whatever on songs. But anyway, yeah, so and obviously, I guess this song is probably a feely kind of song. So let's continue and go on. Pressed to go on, you'll be sorry when I'm gone. Well. I wasn't expecting this. We'll be right back. Adam's song, Blink-182. My eyes are very dry. I'm sorry. All right, so yeah. Blink-182 and Adam's song for the second time. Yeah, I didn't know what to expect here. And obviously, it was kind of a feely song, so I'm kind of excited, I guess, to read what this is about, because I don't know what's going on. Well, I know what's going on, I guess, but yeah, let's just get into this, I guess. So a popular song by Blink-182, describing a young boy's suicide note. It's a break from their usual lighthearted material, which, yeah, I can agree with. I mean, I don't think all of their stuff is lighthearted, but I haven't heard it all. But obviously, this is not very, like, funny or whatever, like some other songs that they've done. But in the end, But the end is still life-affirming as he decides not to go through with it. So yeah, that's what I got at the end of the song there. It said, like, he said the same line over, but he changed some words or whatever to, like, show that he didn't die or whatever. So yeah, it was just very, the whole song was just very different. So it says, it says, the tour is over, I've survived, I can't wait till I get home to pass the time in my room alone. And before that, it was, the tour is over, we'd survived, couldn't wait till I got home to pass the time in my room alone. So yeah, he kind of changed it, but yeah, I can see a little change there, and I noticed that. And anyway, yeah, the song is very good. I like this song, I'll say off the bat. I didn't say that yet, but I really like the song, and I want to hear it again at some point. But anyway, so yeah, it says, Adam is used as a metaphor towards Mark's depression. So, okay, so Mark Hoppus, the guy who sang it, I guess, yeah. So, yeah, I didn't know that he had, like, depression. So, like, this is all a new experience here. So it said, Mark's depression he experienced while on tour with Blink-182. He stated Tom and Travis always had girlfriends waiting back home, so they had something to look forward to at the end of the tour, but I didn't. So it was like I was lonely on tour, but then when I got home, it didn't matter there because I was also lonely there. And so, yeah, pretty much it. And it says some other things, but don't really have to read that. So, yeah, it goes on to say, Hoppus says that he was single at the time. So it says, it's a suicide note set to music, but Hoppus says he wrote it about being lonely on tour. The couplet, I couldn't wait till I got home to pass the time in my room alone, originally ended to get off the plane alone. Tom and Travis always had girlfriends, so he says the same quote. So yeah, obviously with, and also I want to say just like a shout out, whatever, for Tom and Travis, I mean, and Mark, this whole band, like, they're a popular band, but it's for a reason. And obviously now Tom has gone on to do his own thing, and they have Matt Skiba, I think, as lead singer, whatever. So yeah, it's all different now. But anyway, for the time in the early 2000s, anyway, they were big for a reason. And yeah, so let's go on and look at some annotations. There's a lot of annotations because this song is popular. So anyway, it says, I laugh the loudest, who'd have known? So it says, generally people who are the most outgoing and are the most, like, funny or whatever are the ones who have depression and hurt the most, I guess. So, and then it says, I traced the cord back to the wall, no wonder it was never plugged in at all. This line references a near-death experience that Tom DeLonge encountered back when Blink practiced in a garage. DeLonge's guitar amp was in a puddle of water. If it was plugged in, it would have killed him. And so, yeah. I also heard something about that happen. And I heard about someone dying from, like, a mic that was electrocuted or whatever. He was electrocuted and he died. And I just heard it from somewhere. I think it was an old band from the 60s or something like that. But anyway, that crossed my mind. So let's move on. So then it says, I took my time. I hurried up. The choice was mine. I didn't think enough. So that was the Nirvana line. And it says here, alluding to Nirvana's Come As You Are. This line again touches on the narrator's failed suicide attempt. So the Nirvana line was, take your time. Hurry up. The choice is yours. Don't be late. So yeah, obviously Nirvana was influential on many bands. I'm too depressed to go on. You'll be sorry when I'm gone. So some people who commit suicide like to think that they will receive the attention that they deserve only after ending their life. The lack of emotion and attention could be a testament to why they hated their life. So, yeah. And then also somebody added, Adam, the narrator, thinks he will receive the attention that he deserves only after ending his life. This lack of others' affection would have contributed and reinforced Adam's depression. So obviously this whole song is a lot about depression, obviously, and feeling alone. So yeah, this is a very feely song. So then we go on to the first chorus. I never conquered, rarely came. This lyric is a reference to Julius Caesar's famous quote, I came, I saw, I conquered. And Adam never had a chance to succeed. He rarely managed to even get to the first stage of the first stage of success rarely came is likely a subtle sexual reference to express the singer's sexual frustration, which also kind of crossed my mind as another like way of what that as how that can be taken. So yeah, 16 just held such better days. So obviously, pretty much that when you're younger, I guess the days were easier, I guess. So it says the death happens at 17 and he looks back at the previous year as having been so much better. And yeah, obviously when you're depressed and you look back on days that you were happy, you're going to be thinking that was a lot better to live for, whatever. So yeah. And then we go on, the world was wide, too late to try, the tour was over, we'd survived. I couldn't wait till I got home to pass the time in my room alone. So the world is a place of infinite possibilities. However, if you aren't willing to take advantage of this, then the world the world has infinitely little possibilities. Goodness gracious. So yeah, obviously it's still the whole theme of depression and darkness going on in this whole song. And then this line, what was this from? The second verse. This verse is probably the most compelling one I got out of the whole song. It says, I never thought I'd die alone. Another 6 months, I'll be unknown. Give all my things to my friends. You'll never step foot in my room again. You'll close it off, board it up. Remember the time that I spilled a cup of apple juice in the hall. Please tell mom this is not her fault. This is a lot of information in, like, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 lines. So yeah, with the whole give all my things to all my friends, this line acts as a will, stating that he wants to be done with this stuff after suicide. People who commit suicide have been known to give away their possessions before they go through with it. And then you'll never step foot in my room alone, or again, you'll close it off, board it up. And then people usually want to stop remembering things that hurt them and block them off in their heads so they can get over the sadness / depression. So after the suicide, the parents and friends usually won't step in the room again because they will be flooded with memories, and which will have them have an emotional breakdown, most likely. So yeah, I can agree with that. And remember the time I spilled the cup of apple juice in the hall. So Mark Hoppus has said that this line is about when he was a kid. His parents were headed for a divorce. They were arguing in their room behind a closed door, and I was in the hallway, Mark was in the hallway, listening, frightened to the muffled voices. Suddenly the noise stopped, the door opened, and I ran, spilling my apple juice. So, yeah, I don't know, it's kind of a funny picture, but also it's a sad picture, obviously. Yeah, so with that line, and also that makes me think with the whole, you'll never step foot in my room again, which, because, like, I know some people who have died at, like, a young age, or either way, even at any age, I've never had it happen to me yet, where it's like someone close has like died and said, what do you do with everything and what do you do with their room? So it's like, do they always like, I don't know, I guess that's a question for parents, where it's like, what have they done if like their son or daughter or whatever died? It's like, it's a hard thing. Like, what do you do? Like, do you board up the room or whatever? Like, it's very tough to go through, and obviously no one wants to go through it. And yeah, so this song really touches a lot of people, and yeah, it's like very feely, I guess, like I said. So anyway, the last chorus here, the ending of the song, so it says, the tour's over, I've survived, I can't wait till I get home to pass this time in my room alone. So it says, notice the change of we'd survive to I've survived from the previous chorus, which I said earlier. Mark is talking about himself in particular, getting over the loneliness of being on tour. And somebody added, it could also mean that he survived the war against himself. So yeah, obviously the ending is kind of more upbeat or whatever than the beginning was. And also I did see here that somebody did like die, or they committed suicide listening to this song. And then Mark had something to say about that, I think. And it said like that the song isn't a suicide song. It's more of a uplifting song to help you away from those thoughts. So yeah, either way, this was obviously, I guess, controversial in some ways, and a popular song by the Views here, and for good reason. I liked Mark's vocal delivery. I like Travis's drumming, and obviously Tom DeLonge's there, and I really like him, and I like his voice. Obviously he didn't sing in the song, and I'm rambling on now, but anyway, great band, great song, a lot of things to talk about here. And very relatable for many people, me included, I guess. And yeah, it's just a lot of things that are said here that are thought of in a lot of people's heads, and you never know what someone's going through, so that's always always got to be careful. So yeah, obviously I hope Mark's doing better now. Obviously there's many years later now, and hopefully he's got that all under control. I don't know if he has a wife or something now. He probably does, I might think. But anyway, I guess that's it. So thanks for watching. Thanks for liking and subscribing and commenting and all that stuff. 2019 was a nice year for this. Well, that's, I guess, when I started like making more videos. So, and it's nice to see that other people are still here and supporting the whole channel, I guess, and watching and requesting things. So that's very well appreciated. And I am happy to be here and doing this. So yeah, I guess that's it. I'll talk to you guys soon. And hopefully this video doesn't get taken down. Okay.